It is saddening and heartbreaking in terms of the other areas now. To learn, for example, of teacher-learner sexual relations, as in the recent alleged case in Owangwena region. It is saddening. A case that is being investigated. Regional directors, the HR officers, the inspectors of education, and the head office staff members are urged to draw on the relevant laws and regulations in place to bring the perpetrators to book.
In her address, Hansa Himarwa also expressed concern with a huge backlog of new infrastructure, the need to renovate and upgrade existing aging ones.
We have seen on various media, including the social media, the circulation of videos of the poor schooling environment of some of our learners and teaching staff. And I must therefore reiterate the need for improvement in this regard by calling upon on those entrusted with this responsibility within the ministry and outside to turn around this situation and ensure that capital projects are well managed and completed on time for the benefit of our education system.
Hansa Himarwa says her ministry will continue deploying qualified teachers at pre-primary level in order to improve literacy and numeracy rates. She also revealed that the National School Feeding Program is so far feeding about 365,000 learners across the country.
That is out of about 800,000 learners that we are having in the entire schooling system in Namibia. But we need to add more because we know that the number 365 is not the only group of learners that are in need of the mid-morning meal. Therefore, we need to accelerate and improve on our efforts so that we expand on the pool of children that are benefiting from the school feeding program.
The ministry also advised her staff to acquaint themselves with the ministry customer service charter of 2017 and the strategic position of the ministry as outlined by its strategic plan of 2018.